All right, guys, how's it going? A new age here, your coach of the Antelope Valley Aggrons, and we are in a week number 3 of the WPA, the World Pokemon Association, and this week we're up against Jacob, the coach of the Green Bay Pikachus, the founder of the WPA, and, I am so nervous for this battle. I don't even know what to think. Believing in myself is very difficult right now. I want to say, though, all I do at least care about is that I have a good time and the battle goes well in some ways. I don't know. That's all I could say, I guess. But we are currently both 2-0. Neither of us have lost so far. But because we're both 2-0, that means that after this battle, one of us is not gonna have a perfect record anymore. Unless we tie, that'd be some weird shenanigans right there. But anyways, we got the team builder. I'll try and put that down below. I mean, if not, it's in the playlist. But Jacob's information will be down below, his YouTube and Twitter, so you can check out his side of the battle, all that good stuff. Let's stop the waiting and all that, and let's get this battle started. All right, let's see what he's bringing. Okay. All right, so he's bringing Cryogonal, Fortress, Blissey. All right, this is kind of cool because I told myself if he brings more bulk than offense, I might have a chance here. So he's bringing Cryogonal, Fortress, Blissey, Hawlucha, Ninetales, and Nidoking. I'm not gonna go over what we're bringing, just cause I need to focus, I'm too nervous. Alright. I don't know what Cryogonal is. If it's his hazard remover, or like a specially defensive wall. And Ninetales might actually be scarfed, which I don't know. I don't think I'm okay with. But you know what? Actually, it's looking like if I can maybe get rid of Cryogonal, I can kind of wall him with, possibly, with Sigilyph. But we're gonna go according to the plan. Start with Sigilyph, what am I, and let's see how this battle goes. Alright, let's see who we got. Gotta stay focused. Gotta try so hard. Also, I want to say it's nighttime. Sorry if the lighting is weird. Just wanted to get that out of the way. Alright, so he is actually gonna start off with Hawlucha, which is good and bad. He's Mold Breaker. Okay, so he's not Unburdened. And keep that in mind. I think I will just go straight away for the trick, just because I know I could take any hit from this, and whatever he wants to switch out into, I don't think we'll appreciate the choice scarf. Even if it's like Nidoking or Fortress, Blissey, none of them. So I'm gonna go for trick right off the bat. And he's actually gonna go for U-turn, and he's faster, so he is scarfed. So he already has a choice scarf on him. So that's good to know. I actually kind of like that better. But let's see who he's going out into. His choice scarf and has U-turn. So that means he can't set up on me with that. And he's actually going to go out into his Cryogonal. And we're going to go for the trick right here. We'll see what kind of item he was. He might be Life Orb or something. Nevermelt Ice. Okay. So he was Nevermelt Ice. Now he is choice scarf. Which I'm going to change that to choice scarf. Alright. So he might have just been an offensive variant. But I think he also might have given himself the Nevermelt Ice to make sure that he can hit certain things harder, one of them possibly being Cryogonal. So this thing's speed, it will be able to outspeed us, and he definitely could have Freeze Dry. So what do we go out into here? I think Goose is a good option. I also don't want him to double. I feel like he would be expecting maybe my Conkeldurr to want to come in, So I feel like he's either going to go for Toxic or maybe try and switch out. But I also don't want to try and predict wrong that early in the game. We also know it's Helucha's Choice Scarf, so that's interesting. I don't know if Helucha gets Trick. I think Goose is my best bet. We do have Heal Bell for later, and we could potentially start to get Trick Room up. Yeah, so he is going to double, which I thought he would. He does double a lot. And he's going to go out into his Ninetales. Okay. So he's a Drought Ninetales. He is faster than us for sure. We're going to go out into Goose right here. And we get the download for the attack, so he's not necessarily bulky. So we don't get a special attack boost here. Now, as far as I know on the calcs, there shouldn't be anything he can really do to us. Let's see. Yeah, Energy Ball, Fire Blast, all that. Tri-Attack does decent damage to him, but we are going to go for the Trick Room right now. He's going to go for the Fire Blast. Oh, and that's in the sun. Crap. Why does that do so much? He's not Life Orb. Alright, he had to have been Choice Specs for it to do that much damage. Because otherwise, there's no way it would have done anywhere near that. So he's Choice Specs with Fire Blast. I really didn't want him to be Choice Specs. I'm going to keep track of how many Fire Blasts he has used as well. Because it might come down to something like that. So, alright. So something to keep in mind, he is Choice, so he's locked into that. Meaning, he might try and go out into Cryogonal. I also can't switch here. I think I'd rather just recover since I do take it somewhat well. And he can always miss. So I am going to recover for right now, and that's one turn of Trick Room up. So there's four turns left right now. He's going to go out into the Fortress. I really don't want him to set up hazards on me like that. Alright. So Fortress will be faster than me. That's something, you know, keep in mind, obviously. Tri-Attack can do decent damage to him, and he can also set up hazards. I'm actually going to go for Magic Coat right here. Because that's exactly why I brought this thing. So we can at least get a little hazards up. So we're going to bounce back the spikes on him. So we get a layer of spikes up on his side as well. Alright, so that's two turns left to Trick Room. And we will actually be faster. I don't know if I want to attack here or not. I'm actually going to be stubborn and go for Magic Coat again. Porygon is going to do a lot of work this game. Because he has to make a choice here. Either to go for an offensive move or not. He will be faster otherwise. But there's no reason to stall this out. Because he won't be able to do any damage to us. So he does have Toxic as the last move. The Sunlight Faded. And this will be the last turn of Trick Room right here. And then we will be faster. So he has... Oh, I need to get down what moves he has. So he has Spikes and he has Toxic. I feel like What Am I is possibly a good Pokemon to go out into right now. Because Fortress, if he has Gyro Ball, it does a decent amount, but we'll get the, so he has one more turn here. So yeah, I'm gonna go for Magic Coat again. And he can just switch here. So now Trick Room will wear off. And he's going to go out into his Blissey. So we got the spikes up. That's really nice. And I don't know what he's going to try and do to me here, necessarily. Because Blissey can do a lot of things. I don't think he's going for a status move, though. He actually might be an offensive Blissey. But what would he have as an offensive Blissey that could hit me? He could have Focus Blast, I guess. I think I'm going to go out into What Am I? Just to possibly trick Blissey. I don't want to send out Conkeldurr just yet. Even though I could outspeed this thing. Yeah, it's just going to go straight away for Seismic Toss. We actually don't see an item on it. How fast is Conkeldurr? Conkeldurr actually does now speed Blissey. Alright. So he's got a Seismic Toss on the Blissey. I don't know what item yet. I don't know if I should Roost here or Trick. Because if I Trick, or if I go for Trick Room right here. Because I don't expect him to stay in. But I also don't want to switch anything into this. Because what this could do is invite in Ninetales potentially. And I can't go up against Ninetales very well. He's definitely got a switch right here. But into Ninetales, I don't know. And we are faster than Nidoking. Maybe into Coragonal. I'm gonna go for the Trick Room. Yeah, so he's gonna withdraw. Let's see. If he goes Coragonal, that works out very well, because then we could possibly go into Steelix. So we're gonna get the Trick Room off on this thing too. With What Am I? And I think now it has a Choice Scarf. So who could we go out into? I think Vance for Days is good because I do a lot of damage to Fortress as well. He doesn't really have a switch for this. I actually just want to see really quick what moves this thing has access to. Alright, yeah, it doesn't get anything crazy. I'm going to go out into Vance for Days here. He might just Rapid Spin even, if he doesn't want to keep these hazards up to hurt his Ninetales and Fortress. So he's actually going to pull a double here, but we will have the speed that we need. So he's actually going to go out into Blissey. I don't know what this wants to do to me, but nothing wants to take a Drain Punch right here. I actually want to see the damage. Also, that was one turn. He went into Coragonal. It's turn four. So right now there's three. Wait. First turn, I used Trick Room. He went Coragonal. Then I switched just now. I switched for turn four, so this is turn three. Alright. Now I want to see what kind of damage we could do right here. Drain Punch one-shots this thing. So yeah, I'm definitely going for Drain Punch because even if he wants to go Hawlucha, we can knock it out afterwards. Same with Nidoking. Oh, he has a berry, of course. Okay, so now he has no item. That does a crazy amount of damage. Life Orb, Iron Fist. Oh my gosh, and he has counter. I didn't think about counter. Damn it. Conkeldurr could have swept him at the end. And you know what? Now he's going to be... Steelix should still be slower. Can't believe I didn't think about counter. That was like really obvious too. I've seen him run counter. Alright, so we have to go out into Steelix here. We're on two turns left. But this will not allow him to recover. Damn it. Conkeldurr did so good against his team too. Under Trick Room. That really helped me beat Fortress as well. Alright, here... So he does have counter on this. I mean, it's not really going to matter now. He's going to be gone. I think I'm just going to go for Heavy Slam. That's probably my best bet, even if he wants to go into Fortress. Yeah. He is still actually going to try and save this thing. But I didn't want him to go out into a potential Flying type. And we can actually see what kind of Fortress he is right here. I really regret not leaving Fire Fang on, but at the same time, it was worth it. So he is a Leftovers Fortress. Alright, and this is going to be the last turn of Trick Room right here. And we know he has Toxic. I actually don't think he can beat my... I actually don't think he can beat my Vaporeon. But I might want to try and heal up against this thing. Where's... With, Sigilyph. How much HP am I at? I'm at 47%. Gyro Ball is sketchy. If he even has Gyro Ball, which I definitely could see. But I'm going to try and go out into this right now. Trick Room should wear off this turn, so we should be faster. So he goes for Protect. Okay. So he has Protect. Alright. And Leftovers. He does still have Croagunel. So I think for now, I might just Roost. See, damn it, now I don't have a switch for Croagunel. Yeah, I'm not going to trick again to give him his item back. Damn it. I'm gonna assume he's like offensive rapid spinner. So freeze dry. If he was ice beam with never melt ice, then that did have a shot to kill me. Still does a lot. It can almost one shot me. Right now he's Scarf though, so he can't really make the same kind of plays. I'm gonna go for Trick Room because Ice Beam does not knock me out. And after that we could be faster. So he is gonna Rapid Spin. Alright. Yeah. So. Just assuming he is like the offensive spinning set. And now he's stuck in that. So I think I want to double his Blissey. I don't want to let it recover. Yeah, I'm going to go out into Underbite because that's my safest option right here. So we're back on turn 4. Because I can't let his Blissey get HP back again. I really regret letting Conkeldurr go down like that. That was a good move on the berry, too. I guess I should have gone for knockoff. That would have been better. So this is going to be difficult with this, like, stalling that we have going on. But I'm going to go for Earthquake. It'll do decent damage to him. He's going to protect. So after this, we'll be on turn two. Alright, I feel like he's just going to try and get spikes up again. He does have Toxic. We'll be on turn one. I don't know if he actually has Gyro Ball now. But the same thing keeps happening. He keeps getting to go into Cryogonal. I kind of want to try and go into Goose, but I don't want him to Toxic me because that forces me to have to switch. And if he is physically defensive, Scald does a decent amount to him. I'm going to go Vaporeon. Because after this, we'll be on turn one. After this, we'll be on the last turn of Trick Room. Yeah, and he's just going to get up spikes there. I feel like he might just protect, but I don't see why he would, if that makes any sense. Kind of want to go for Wish, but if he brings out Ninetales, well, no, I have Goose. Yeah, because I figure he is just going to switch here. I'm going to go for Wish. Oh, he's going to get up another layer of spikes. So Fortress doesn't have Rapid Spin. Yeah, Cryogonal is his spinner. Alright, so we're going to go for Scald here. He's going to withdraw after getting his spikes up. He's going to go Cryogonal, probably. No, he's actually going to go into Blissey, but hopefully this can two-hit KO. Alright, yeah, and we'll be faster now. So Blissey will be gone. Yeah, I can't let him recover with this thing. Too much of a threat. I had to keep putting the pressure on. Granted, I don't think we could get spikes up again, which is real unfortunate. I think after this, it invites in something like Nidoking, which is pretty sketchy. And it could get access to things like Superpower. Does it get like Focus Blast? Oh my gosh, it does. That's not good for my Excadra, actually. So we're going to Scald, we're going to take out the Blissey. Getting rid of the Conkeldurr was huge though. Focus Blast actually knocks me out as well. So I think if we're in against Nidoking, we might just have to stay in. Alright, so we know he's Choice Specs now. Blissey is gone. Choice Specs. Solar Beam. We're specially defensive, so even Choice Specs won't do that much. I'm gonna go for a Wish. Yeah. He actually goes for Will-O-Wisp and misses. He's gotta be locked into that though, right? Because that fire blasted way too much. I know he can go out into Cryogonal, which is annoying, but I'm going for Scald. It actually would have been really nice to get off that damage. I should have gone for Scald. Yeah, so he's staying in. But I already know he's Specs. And he's trying to burn my Vaporeon. Because we would have had him at, yeah, less than half. That would have been really nice. Alright. I don't know if I should Wish here. Yeah, I'm gonna wish again. Because he is gonna withdraw, if not try and be ballsy and stay in and go for Will-O-Wisp again. Yeah, so I'm going for wish here. So that way, Cryogonal shouldn't be able to take me out. Yeah, Freeze Dry doesn't do anywhere near enough. And we're gonna go for a Scald here. Scald actually does nothing to this, so I think I'm just gonna go for a Heal Bell. Get the burn off. Because Cryogonal can't do anything to me. And I'm really afraid that he might be Scarf Nidoking. If he's not, though, then Excadrill can beat it. I'd need to save Excadrill, if anything, because under Trick Room, that can beat Ninetales. Actually, under Trick Room, Steelix can beat Ninetales and Nidoking. I don't know when I'm going to get that opportunity, though. Did I go? No, I went for Heal Bell. Okay. So he's going to go out into Hawlucha here. What can Hawlucha do to me, though? Yeah, we're going to get rid of the burn and be healed back up to full. We know we can't sub. High Jump Kick can actually do a lot of damage to us. But we do have Protect. I'm actually going to Protect. See if he wants to U-turn or if he wants to throw off a High Jump Kick randomly, maybe thinking I didn't have Protect. No, so he's trying to go U-turn again. Alright, so we saw the Sunlight, and now we get to fire off the Scald. U-turn is not going to do that much to us. And we know he's Scarf because he outsped. Should take that fine. Yeah, we do. So Trick Room is working very well against him, but we're not really getting anywhere. And we've already run through half the clock. So some plays need to be made. I do love that Blissey is gone and that Cryogonal is choiced, because now he really doesn't have anything to break my Vaporeon unless he goes into Nidoking. So he's going to go back out into Ninetales. We're going to be able to hit that with another Scald. And we know we could take Solar Beams here. I don't even think I need to like bother trying to switch. Actually, let's make sure. Because that was Timid. And I want to see the modest damage. Timid choice specs. Solar Beam. So that can do up to half. Actually does over half. And I don't know if Scald will be able to knock him out here. I don't know if this is the turn where I try and switch. His Porygon too. He's choice specs and modest. Fire Blast does a lot. Solar Beam doesn't do anything. Actually, I don't have to risk anything. I can go for Protect and see what he's locking himself into. Yeah, it's true. So he is locking himself into Solar Beam. Wait. Why did it only go once? Wait, what was that? So I can switch here into something that could take Solar Beam. I might try and go out in a Goose. Or, sorry, what am I? Because I think he'd be expecting Goose, possibly. Yeah, I'm going to go out into Sigilyph. Also because it doesn't take any damage from hazards or anything. So we know he stayed in. Yeah, so we stayed in to go for Solar Beam because I wasn't switching before. Alright. So now... I think I'm gonna go for Air Slash, maybe? Yeah, I'm gonna go for Air Slash. Because this will cover if he wants to go straight into Fortress, too. Because we've been going in a cycle. And this will do decent damage to Fortress. I don't want to throw up Trick Room just yet. I wish Spikes were still up, though. Because this thing would be getting really weakened. So he does go into Fortress. Alright, that's what I wanted. Oh my gosh, and we missed. Okay. I'm going to Air Slash again. Because Air Slash does decent damage to Fortress from what looks to be physically defensive, and we have a chance to flinch. I really wish that first one hit, because we would have done decent damage to him. He goes for the Toxic, but we are Magic Guard. I don't know if he forgot or what, but we're chilling right here. See, if that first one had hit, he'd be fairly low, actually. So I'm going to go for another Air Slash. Actually, I shouldn't have done that, because he's going to switch into Croagunow now. No, he's going to Protect. Okay. This thing being poisoned doesn't matter, though. Alright, I think now... I might try and go... Underbite? No, I really want to Air Slash because his Croagunow is choice, so it doesn't matter if he goes into that anyways. And he's actually bringing a Nidoking now. So let's see what kind of damage we get on this thing. Decent damage, actually. Now, we are faster than this thing, but he could have Sucker Punch. Let's see. Let's see how much Nidoking can do with Sucker Punch. Because I brought this because it is faster than Nidoking and can stall it out. Sucker Punch doesn't knock us out. Ice Beam does. That's only if he's faster, which he's not. He would have to be Choice Scarfed, and Choice Scarf doesn't look like it knocks us out. Alright, Choice Scarf Ice Beam does have a chance to knock us out. I'm gonna Roost for now, just because I'll be able to take his hit. Alright, and we'll lose the Flying type. I just want to see what he has to go for. Alright, so he has Thunderbolt. And we do take that. Not very well. Alright, so he's not Scarfed, so I'm going to assume he's Life Orb, Sheer Force. Alright. So that being said, he will still knock us out if we decide to trick him right here. I'm actually going to go maybe into Goose. I don't want to go straight into Excadrill or anything yet. Yeah, I'm going to go into Goose for now. Yeah, I still have my Eviolite, so I can take plenty of hits, or should be able to, from this Nidoking. Oh, I forgot about the spikes. My attack rose. So he does decide to go for Sludge Wave there. How much did that do? Crap. I really hope this doesn't knock me out. Actually, he could have Superpower. me at 45. Wow, superpower is a roll to knock me out. I don't know if I can risk this yet. I really don't want to. So we got Sludge Wave as well. I have to go for Trick Room and hope that doesn't knock me out. Come on. It looked like a roll. Alright. Yeah, it wasn't. It wasn't. Alright, so we're going to get the Trick Room off. We will be faster now. And we're just going to go straight for a recover. So Nidoking... Why did my attack go up against Nidoking? My special defense should have gone up. Alright, so he could definitely go for Toxic here. I still don't know what his last move is. He is not cussed at Barry. I mean, it might even be Earthquake. I really don't want to deal with if it is. Oh. I really don't want to go Dig Dug right here. Also, I'm going to keep track of the turns. So 5, turn 4 was just now when I went for cover, so this is turn 3. Damn it. So he's gonna go, he's gotta go for like Toxic here or double out into something. I don't think I wanna go Underbite though. Cause I can't keep up with this thing with the damage. Alright, I need to pay attention to the clock. Excadrill. Fortress. How much does Earthquake do if he has it? Wow, that does a lot. Okay. I'm gonna go out into Vaporeon. I wanna keep the pressure on him. I'm sorry for taking a long time to. I really feel like this might actually come down to the clock. So Gyrobot is his last move. Ooh. I actually really like that. I really like that. Because that means we could come in with Excadrill. And actually do a lot of damage. So he can't touch us. I mean, not a lot of damage, but... you know. Alright, so we already know he's faster. I think, how many turns is this? This is the last turn right here. And part of me wants to go straight into Excadrill. But then that brings in things like Ninetales. Which, because of my team being weakened, I don't really have a switch for. I'm actually gonna go Dig Dug here. Because I don't think he's switching. I think he's gonna go for Toxic or Protect, if anything. And I want to get some of these hazards off the field. So right here, because he's staying in, we get a safe rapid spinoff. And Trick Room's going to wear off. We're going to get off the rapid spin. Yeah, we're going to rapid spin here. Now we know that he can't touch us. Because I really need these hazards gone. And he is faster than us for this one last turn too. Meaning he can't do the whole I rapid spin and then he puts up hazards after me kind of deal. I really don't know who's going to win here. Like I really feel like this might come down to the clock. 100%. But if that's the case, I feel like he has more HP on his mons than I do. Unless it's a tie. If it's a tie, well then we'll see. But he is going to withdraw, so we're going to get this rapid spin off. Who's that? That's Ninetales. Okay. Yeah, I really didn't want Ninetales to come in. How much HP do I have? No, he's Specs. I can't beat this thing. Yeah, my berry's not gonna work on Specs. For sure. This is kind of a huge moment right here. Because if I let this go down, not only does it make it harder for if it comes down to running the clock, but this just beats Nidoking. Because I know it's not Scarf now. So this is a real like 50-50 right now. Vaporeon is at 164, it's at 69%. Solar Beam will not knock us out. But if he does go for Solar Beam, that puts us in a pretty bad position. Granted, we can switch again after that, but Vaporeon will be very weak. I have to go into Vaporeon. This should not be able to knock us out. Solar Beam does 52 to 61%. We're at 69%. So let's see if he makes the right prediction. He does go for the Fire Blast and misses. Oh my gosh, all right, we got super lucky there. Yeah, we got really lucky there. And I'm not complaining. All right. So what this does now, I feel like I need to maybe get some shenanigans going. I think I might try and go into Underbite and double. Actually, let's see who takes it better. No, wait, he's going for Fire Blast, sorry. Because if he tries to go Coragonal right here, actually, you know what? I need to keep playing it safe. I don't care if he goes into Coragonal because it's locked into its attack, and that just gives us a better chance to burn it. Yeah, I really wanted to double into Steelix there, but there was also really no reason to. And I really want to burn this thing. So we know he could have Freeze Dry, but we also know that does nothing to us. So I'm going to go for the Wish. I might actually use this as a chance to heal up some of my Pokemon. Yeah, so he's staying in, going for the Freeze Dry. Yeah, that does not do enough. I really don't want to risk him critting us, though. Because I could go out into something else. I could try and go into Goose. No, but that'll raise my attack. All his Pokemon, so specially defensive. Yeah, I'm just going to protect right here, because I want the HP back. And he doesn't really have anything that could come in on this. Oh, and then it is confirmed that he has Freeze Dry. Actually has a 10% chance to freeze. We have Scald, so never mind. Alright. If he switches into something, that's bad. I'm gonna Scald right here. He actually stays in and goes for Freeze Dry. I didn't think he would. But that's okay. I really want to burn this thing. Can we just burn this?
Oh my gosh.
This is just ending up with him being weakened in the end. I really want to keep going for Scald too, because he might decide to switch at one point. I'm going to go for Scald here because this would be a time for him to switch, I think. No, he stayed in and went for Freeze Dry. The freeze doesn't matter. 10% chance, of course. Come on, can we burn this thing? Thank you. Alright, so now he definitely gets a free opportunity to switch. But that's okay, because all this does is give me HP. Freeze Dry should not be able to knock us out. I wasn't paying attention to exactly how much damage it was doing. 31 to 37. And we're at almost half. And it shouldn't be able to knock us out. Yeah, I need to go for Wish here. Alright, so we're good, and then we can protect this next turn, and hopefully he doesn't go down to burn this turn. Yeah, he's not going down to burn this turn. He'll go down to burn next turn after we protect. Alright, yeah, that's really good. So we're gonna protect here. He can definitely switch here and save that for fodder if he wants to. Yeah, that's... would have been really nice to get that right, but... And I really wish we had the spikes up, because this thing would have been gone by now. And honestly, right here... he really can't do anything. Like, we can just protect and scout. See what he wants to do. Because there's not really a situation where, like, this helps me that much, you know? Yeah, so I'm gonna protect. All I do is get more HP off this. Yeah, so he's going for Solar Beam. Alright. So how much does Solar Beam do? Because I think Scald kills him at this range. I hope. Solar Beam. It says it does 52 to 61, and it's still a lot. Also, he has Solar Beam and Will-O-Wisp, but I didn't fill those in. Is that 152 speed? If he's modest, he actually speed ties with my Excadrill. Which sucks. Because I didn't take into consideration making it faster than a potential modest. Alright, so here... Crap. I don't know who I go out into. I guess Sigilyph can take it. But then who does he have if I go Sigilyph? He has Nidoking. Oh, I don't have enough time to calc this. Crap. Whoa, that does a lot. Okay, I'm going Sigilyph. Does it really do that much? Oh my gosh, that's a 100. I'm so stupid. Oh, we could have beaten up his Solar Beam. Now would be a good time for him to double into Nidoking, which is why I wanted to go Excadrill, but I didn't have time to calc how much Solar Beam does. So he does decide to stay in. Alright. I'm going for Trick Room again. He could go Fortress here for sure. It's really looking like we're gonna run the clock. We have 14 minutes. I'm thinking he might try and go Nidoking here. Yeah, he does. Alright, good. That's what I wanted to happen. Alright, because of the situation with the clock potentially being run down, I really don't want to let anything die if I can help it. Alright, hold on. I want to calc this really quick just so I know. Choice specs. Modest. So Solar Beam would have done half. That's fine. Is there a way to like import this or something? Yeah, I'm gonna assume he's modest. I'm actually going to import this set just so I have it, so I stop trying to click that. Okay. So that was the first turn of Trick Room that I just went for, so we're on turn 4 right now. Alright, so Sigilyph to Nidoking. Alright, so we should be fine to take any hit after we roost. So I'm gonna go for that right now. Oh, we're faster than Nidoking. Oh my gosh. Or slower, duh. Oh, I just made a crazy mistake, but it worked out in our favor. That's scary. And we also know he has Earth Power. Oh, that worked out very well for us. So Nidoking is slower than us. See, now this would be a good time. But I know we take Sludge Bomb and Earth Power, so I'm gonna go into Goose right now. Because then I can heal that as well. I can't just switch into Steelix on this thing, unfortunately. My attack goes up, he goes for the Sludge Wave. See, that would have been a great turn to go into, like, Steelix, but I could not. Okay, hold on, hold on. I'm losing track of the turns. So that was turn 4. Turn 3 was with Roost. This was turn 2. So this should be the last turn. I'm gonna go recover. He's going for Sludge Wave. I really want to make a double into Excadrill now. If I do this wrong, though, it could cost me the game. Alright. This is the last turn of Trick Room. Dig Dug, let's go. Let's hope we got this right. We're being really ballsy right now. If he goes Earth Power, we might have just lost. But if he goes Sludge Wave... Alright, we got him on the Sludge Wave. Trick Room wears off this turn. Alright, this is amazing because... Alright. We can go Earthquake. I don't know what his last move is. He can see I'm not on an Air Balloon, though. Nidoking, Thunderbolt. How much... Flamethrower will not be able to knock us out because of our berry. So we can kind of freely go for Magnet Rise if we want to. I think I am... Yeah, I'm just gonna go for Earthquake, because we will be faster than this thing. And if he wants to go Hawlucha, then we'll just go out into Sigilyph. I mean, that's a really easy switch, but I didn't want to risk it. He actually goes out in a Fortress, which is interesting because he can't touch us. He really can't touch us. There's 9 minutes left on the clock. Yeah, we know his entire set. He cannot touch us. And I think I might actually start going for Iron Head in case he wants to try and double into Hawlucha. I don't want to allow him to let that come in. But I know his set cannot touch me. And I'm not doubling here. I have no reason to. I just want to see what he's trying to do with this. Gyro Ball shouldn't do that much. Kind of does a lot. I don't... Actually, I should save HP on this thing. Actually... I'm going to go into Steelix here. Because now I know he can't touch my Steelix. And Gyro Ball won't hurt me at all. So Steelix should be able to beat this 1v1. Either that or I force him to switch. I really wish I had Fire Fang now. You know what? It's really looking like it's coming down to the clock. And either it's going to be a tie because we have the same amount, or it's going to come down to like one of us winning. I don't know what I should go for. I think I'm just gonna go for Heavy Slam first. He's gonna switch. He goes out in a Frostbite, so that gets sacked. Oh, that is pretty bad though. Because now he gets a free switch into something, which neither one of us have really had that opportunity this whole game. And I don't know if he's gonna go Nidoking or Ninetales. I don't know if I have switches into these things either. Alright, he's gonna go Nidoking. So he has to go Earth Power. Oh, this is kind of bad. He has Thunderbolt. Yeah. Alright. I have to try and make some kind of a prediction. Because if I get this. Alright, he either goes Earth Power or Thunderbolt, right? Thunderbolt. It says Thunderbolt doesn't knock us out. Oh, it's Choice Scarf. Damn it. Thunderbolt does 94%, so that does knock us out if he gets that right. Or if he goes Earth Power. Earth Power, Thunderbolt. Oh my gosh, how much does Vaporeon take, though? Where's Vaporeon? Hold up, hold up. Nidoking, Ice Beam. Thunderbolt. That does half. Alright, I'm gonna go into Sigilyph. Because if we could get Trick Room up and then he takes us out... This is bad. Alright, he goes for Earth Power, so we get that right. Alright. And he doesn't have Coragonal. So I think I want a Trick now. Because... He has Thunderbolt. Okay. So without Life Orb... Without Life Orb, he can't knock us out with Thunderbolt. So I'm gonna Trick. And take his Life Orb. So Thunderbolt should not be able to knock us out. If he does have Ice Beam, that'll knock us out now. So he goes for Sludge Wave. And he's gonna be doing significant amount less now. I don't know if I should Roost or... What I should go for. Sigilyph, Nidoking. Life Orb, Air Slash does 50 to 60%. Which. I don't. Yeah, that's a ridiculous roll. I'm not risking that. Should I Roost though? Sludge Wave is doing a lot. I'm gonna Roost. Just to see if maybe Ice Beam is his last move. So Sludge Wave does 160 to 76. So 89. 160 to 76. So that's 80. 84. Yeah, it does enough to knock me out. Alright, because here's the thing. If I Trick Room here... No, because he still has Fortress. Alright, you know what? I'm going to go for Air Slash. Alright, come on, let's see that damage. And we could potentially flinch him. Damn it. Alright, so Nidoking's gonna take us out. So we have the same amount of Pokemon down right now. But we can go Excadrill. If we go Excadrill, that brings in Ninetales. afterwards. So I don't think I should go Excadrill. I think I'm gonna go Goose. He's not Life Orb anymore. So we should. Yeah, we can definitely take a Sludge Wave now. And I think I wanna go for Trick Room. Yeah, I'm gonna Trick Room. There's 2 minutes left. Sludge Wave should not knock us out at all. Alright, yeah. And now we can recover. I don't know what's gonna happen now. The clock is gonna run out. But we're gonna recover here. And he's gonna withdraw. Possibly in a fortress. If he goes fortress though, that kinda doesn't do anything for him. Alright, well, unless we have some crazy way to knock this out. Which we really don't, because I didn't bring Fire Fang like I wanted. But that's okay. We're just going to go into Steelix here. You know what? Time is running out. Turn 2. Trick Room. And I don't even have a switch after Trick Room. I might go back out into Goose. I still have one more turn, right? I'm just gonna Heavy Slam. He's gonna Protect. So this will be turn 1. And I think my best play is to go into Goose in case he tries to go into Ninetales. Yeah. I mean, I could have just Earthquaked if I thought he was going to do that. Oh, he might go Hawlucha. Oh, crap. Oh, it's not good. You know what? The time ran out. Honestly, that's all there is. And it is in my better interest to play out this last turn because I don't, or to not play out this last turn because I don't know what's gonna happen here. Because if he goes High Jump Kick, he could do a lot of damage. Yeah, I'm gonna let the clock go. That's what's in my better interest if it goes based off HP. Because I could potentially lose a Pokemon if I played out this turn. Which, he did put me in a good position there. Or himself, I should say. But that's it. I don't know if there's another turn. Or how this works. Because this is really sketchy. Actually, no. Porygon will be fine. Because I gave myself enough HP for this. Hawlucha, High Jump Kick, 252, Adamant, does not knock me out. Yeah, High Jump Kick does 60 to 70. So, my best bet is to stay in. And, I guess Trick Room. Oh, okay. It gave us the win. It did it off HP then. It completely did off HP. And it was based off of, who was it that was super weak? Nidoking. Because Nidoking was almost dead. Hey. I don't know how I feel about that, to be honest. Like, I really don't enjoy winning games like that. But if that's what it came down to, I'm gonna save the video in case I decide to like post-com over this. I might cut out this part because I'm gonna talk to Jacob real quick and then I'll do the outro and everything. Well, I'm just gonna say from now then, I kind of wish they actually would play out that last turn right before the timer goes up, because say, like, if he crit me with high jump kick, I would have died and had less Pokemon than him, and then he would have won. So that would have actually been really interesting, and that would have been a cool way to lose if that were the case. But I guess both of our teams, if I had Fire Fang, if I had kept Fire Fang on Steelix, because, alright, my mentality was, I changed Steelix to Chesto Resto last minute, because when I was testing the team, if he had brought a lot of offense, Steelix would not have been able to survive through Trick Room long enough to be able to sweep and put on offensive pressure on his team. So I decided to go with a more, with a Steelix that had more longevity, because that would have allowed me more opportunities to bring in Steelix, sweep, and then take it back out after Trick Room. Because otherwise, if I would have kept Fire Fang, there's no way Fortress would have been able to stay in like that during Trick Room. And that would have forced other things to come in, which if it was still under Trick Room, I could have then Heavy Slammed or Earthquaked, and it would have taken him out. So I think if we actually would have had the more offensive Steelix, then I definitely would have won just based off the Pokemon that he brought, because I knew if he brought a more defensive team, that he would have had the defensive Pokemon and then the fast, hard-hitting Pokemon, and because of Trick Room, we would have been able to beat those Pokemon, so we would have just ended up with a team of full defense, which I guess how things worked out could not beat through our defense of our team, because this whole game ended up being defense versus defense, especially since he took out my Conkeldurr at the beginning, which could have put in a lot of work and a lot of offensive pressure on his team. So, you know, I don't like that I won through the time running out, but just the fact that I was able to hold off and keep going at it with him throughout that battle, I actually really, I'm okay with the outcome. And you know what? Jacob is a great battler, and if I do happen to make it to the finals, I already know Jacob's gonna be there anyways, so he will definitely have another chance at me sometime in the future. Even if not this league, whatever other league we end up doing together. but that was a really good game. I really liked the back and forth of it all. So good game, Jacob. Be sure to check out his side down below. I guess I won't do a post-com, because I know Jacob does post-coms, and there's nothing wrong with that. But I figure since I know he's going to do a post-com, I'll at least have my side live, so you can have both a post-com and a live side, just to kind of see how it all went down. But yeah, guys, that's going to be the battle. The time running out, we're now 3-0, undefeated so far. If that's what you want to call it, but it is what it is, and crazy things happen in league format games, so I'm just going to take it as a win and focus on week 4. So if you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like, be sure to check out Jacob, his Twitter and YouTube down below, and until then, I'm New Age Steel, keep on watching. I'll see you guys in week 4. Later, guys.